Hi everyone, in this video I'll be demonstrating how to install Arista VEOS instance into emulated virtual environment. For testing this out, you need to have a emulated virtual environment instance with enough RAM and CPU for devices to run. And for EVE, you can download the free version from their official site, the community version. And you can install it on top of ESXi kind of hypervisor, or you can even install it on bare metal or on Linux. I'll be creating a separate video for that, how to install it on ESXi or any other hypervisor. For Arista image, either you can download it from arista.com website if you have proper privileges, or you can get it from authorized partner. So for downloading the image, you need to go to arista.com site, support software download. Once you come down here, you can see different versions of images. EOS is mainly for production. We'll be using VEOS lab for this. This is a software which is supposed to use for proof of concepts, configuration testing, feature testing and all. So I'll be using that software. And here I'll be using the version 4.17.10m. For the same software version, you can see here multiple files. This VirtualBox file is to install it in VirtualBox instances. This SWI file is a file can be used for upgrading or downgrading the switch directly. You can just upload it as an image file. VMDK is the actual device hard disk file. Earlier, for Arista image to run, we need two components. One is a boot image and another is the device hard disk VMDK file. A boot image will work as a bootloader for Arista image. The main purpose of the boot of image is to read the boot config file in the flash and load the image for booting. Now Arista has introduced another file called combined file. There even a boot and actual VMDK is combined and you can use it as a single image file. In this demonstration, I'll be using the previous method, a boot plus VMDK. Combined file, I haven't tried it yet. Once I figure out how to install combined file, I'll create another video for that. I think from the device behavior perspective, there won't be any difference if you use combined or separate boot image plus VMDK. For installing the Arista image into EVE, you need to download these two files. I'll be using boot-veos 8.0. The purpose of serial file is to, when booting up VEOS, it will send the console output to the serial port. Since it is a simulation, we don't need that. We'll be seeing it anyway in the direct console, so we'll use boot VEOS-8.0. You need to download these two files. And then VEOS-lab 4.17.10m. These two files we need to download. You can see our boot file is a very small file, it is only 5 MB. This is 5veos.vmdk is 581 MB. To save the time, I have already downloaded and kept the file in my folder, so I'll be cancelling this download now. These are the two files which I have downloaded from arista.com site. Now we'll go to EVE and see their recommendation of installing Arista into the environment. To see that, you can go to the documentation, QEMU image namings. Here you can see, if you come down and check for VEOS, the naming convention what they say is VEOS hyphen, and the file name, the VMDK file should be converted to QCO2 and file name should be HDA, and the ISO image abort-eos should be renamed to cdrom.iso. The naming is very important in Eve. Here you can see they have clearly mentioned, for example, for the folder name Firepower, if you are installing Firepower, this name is very important. Later the second part you can give any version number or anything else as per your wish, but this folder name is very important, folder name and image name, and image format should be QCO2. So first we need to convert this VMDK into the QCO2 format. So we'll do that first. I'll go to that folder, data slash you can see these two files. I'll be converting this VEOS into QCO2. The command is img space convert -f then vmdk space -o. Output format is going to be QCO2. Then the file name is VEOS, is my actual file name, and my destination file name, what they recommends is hda.qco2, so I'll give that name. hda.qco2. It will take a while to convert the file. Yeah, now I have hda.qco2 file. Now we need to create a folder name here. The name Eve recommends is VEOS hyphen. So folder name, I'll copy that, create a folder here, VEOS hyphen, the version number must probably be 4.17.10m, and I'll copy. Yeah, we need to rename even the ISO file. ISO file name should be cdrom.iso. cd.iso. Need to copy these two files into VEOS. Then you need to copy this to the folder in Eve. So I'll show the folder location from the FileZilla. You can copy it using any method. I'll be using FileZilla. You can even scp to the folder. You need to go to OPT folder. There, UNET lab, add-ons, QEMU, here. This folder you need to copy and paste. You can see here, I have already copied it for reducing the time, so I won't be copying it again. Once copying is completed, you need to set the permission for the Eve folder. So I'll be SSHing to the Eve environment, So C7250 is my email wrong and IP. For setting the permission, the command is slash opt unet lamp wrappers unl wrapper hyphen a, then fix permissions. So that it will apply the permission to even the copied file. Once you do that, go to the EU, add an object, click on Arista VEOS. If you have multiple VEOS, it will be listing here. I'll show it in the folder structure. I already have one more image with the same folder. The naming starts with VEOS, so it maps to that device. So I have two devices available for Arista. So this is the image which I installed now. So I'll select that. You can give the name. So RAM, you need to give as per the Arista's recommendation. It varies, depends on the image size and image versions. Since it is just a demo, I'll give 4 GB. CPU, I'll give 2 CPUs. Even you can edit the Ethernet interfaces, number of Ethernet interfaces needed. Save. Now for connecting this to external network, I'll add a network here. I'll map this to management cloud. I'll drag and drop here. The management interface of Arista, I'll connect to my cloud. You need to start the instance. Open the console. Now it is booting. It may take 2 to 3 minutes to boot up. I'll pause the video. Once the device is up, I'll continue again. Device came up now. I'll give the default username and password. The default username is admin. Give enable. We'll verify the config. There is no configurations. We'll check the zero touch status. Show zero touch. Zero touch is disabled. Now we'll start configuring the device for accessing from outside. Command is configure. I'll configure a host name. SW/ST7.200. That is the IP I'm going to configure for the device. We'll configure the management IP interface M1. IP is going to be 192.168.67.200/24. Default route, IP route, ST7.254 is my default gateway. We'll configure a username. Username admin. Secret admin, privilege 15, I'll save the config. Now we'll try pinging to the device. it is reachable. We'll check the SSH. It is working. Verify the config. By default API won't be enabled. We'll verify that as well. Copy the IP, HTTPS. API is not working as of now. You can see page is not loading. Now we'll go to the search console, the commanders. Is one API HTTP commands notion. Reload the page. Now we are getting the certificate error. Yeah, we can give the username and password. Enable. Enter. Show version. Submit the request. You can see the JSON format of your request here. Here we are getting the output in the JSON format. Yeah. Now both API and SSH is working. I have installed Arista in Eve environment. I hope this video was helpful. To stay up to date with my latest videos, please subscribe to my channel. I'll be creating more videos on latest networking technologies with real-time examples. So thanks for watching. See you in the next video.